As we have seen in the discussion on the cap theorem and Bayes, we have to trade off consistency and availability. And we consider the following read-write pattern. When you're writing to the system, which consists of multiple machines and maintains multiple replicas for your object, you're writing to a subset of these machines. This is guaranteed. And when you're reading, you're also reading from a subset of the machines. And this can be configured as a trade-off between consistency and availability. It can happen that you have multiple versions of a certain object, and in the end, if there is a conflict that cannot be resolved, then we have to see in the application how we are dealing with it. This comes a bit later. So here's an illustration of the logical anatomy of a write. So here's the client writing to our system. So this box here is our system, which in this case contains one coordinator. This task can also be distributed, but let's just say for the simplicity, there's some service here that we call coordinator we are writing to. And then this coordinator will send the write request to all of the servers, to all of the three nodes in this case, and will wait for responses that the write was successful. So when we are writing as a client, we can set a request that we want to have the acknowledgement of the write when we have two or more nodes where the write was successful. All right, so in this case now, when the coordinator would send the write requests, let's say here and here and here, so to all of them in this case, and here for node 1 and 2, the write was already processed. Then the response goes back to the coordinator, and the coordinator will see that two of these have successfully written, and then the OK is sent back to the client. It does not mean that only node 1 and 2 will have the update. Node 3 will also eventually get it, but we require only that two of the three have processed the write before we tell the client OK. And now you see already by the name I just mentioned, or the word I said eventually, the write will be processed by all of the nodes. And this is exactly the name of eventual consistency, where this comes from. So eventually all the replicas will be updated, but there can be a short amount of time when there is only a subset that have the write and not all of them. So in summary again, the client sends the write request. If we have n replicas, then the coordinator will send the write request to all of the replicas. However, the server does not wait until all of the writes have been processed, but W of these are enough. That's important. So we want to send to all of the nodes, but we will not wait until all of these nodes have processed the write, but we will send OK back to the client if W out of N have already successfully processed the write. That's the important part. And when a client is reading, we are returning back after reading R out of N replicas. So R out of N nodes we are accessing. So this, of course, if you're setting R strictly smaller than N, then it means that we are not waiting for all of the nodes to be contacted, which of course makes the return much faster than if you would wait for even the slowest of the nodes to reply. Depending how you're setting this, you can configure this either to guarantee consistency or to have also the case of multiple conflicting versions of a data object. And we will see how we can set this to guarantee consistency or to be in the eventual consistency mode. So when W is smaller than N, we can have the following situation. We have here four nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4. And here we are insisting on the write to three of these four nodes, and it takes of course some time to reach also the node 3. In the end we will have of course also the node 3 updated, so here also the D1 version is there, but here in this point in time this node 3 still has the old version, right? So this is not consistent at this point in time here. If we would read only from this node 3. But it's also clear if we are now reading from, let's say in this case, two nodes, we will always have one node, at least one node, that has the latest version. So even in this inconsistent state here, when we are reading from more than one, we still can guarantee that we have a consistent view of the data. Eventual consistency is the point in time when the write was not processed by all, until the point when eventually the write is processed by all. So here we have the situation, the time point, when the client receives the acknowledgement after W writes have been processed. And here's a point in time when the nodes, or all of the nodes, have the updated value. And this time in between is the time of possibly inconsistent data, also of course dependent on the number of reads we are doing, so the number of nodes we are reading from. So how can we now configure the system in the way that we can guarantee consistency? The first configuration here is called write to all. In write to all, we are just setting the parameter W to be equal to N. So we are waiting before the client gets the acknowledgement until all the writes have been acknowledged. So all of the nodes have been updated. And this means we have a consistent view. So if you're writing or insisting to write to all, and then only the client will get the notification. In this case, it's enough to read from one, and still we are guaranteed to get the latest version, right? So they all have been updated, and then one read is enough. And this, of course, is good if we have a system where we're expecting very many reads, but very few writes, because here the writes are, of course, a bit slower, because we are waiting until all of these writes have been processed. We can also go the other extreme. This is called consistency by read from all. So in this case here, R is set to N. So we're reading from all of the machines and have only W equals 1. In this case here, we see we have the updated value here and we're reading from all. So independent of that, we see also some old data here. Because we're reading from all, we will also see this updated data. So it's guaranteed to see the last version. Now this is summarized, so the process is summarized in the so-called WARS model of Amazon Dynamo. This was one of the first key value stores developed by Amazon, as you can guess. And here it's illustrated exactly what I mentioned already, the way how the client is talking, or the coordinator is talking to the individual nodes. So here we have the configuration, N replicas we have, and the coordinator is sending to all of the N replicas. That's important to notice. So we will not write only to W, but we always send to all of the replicas. But we're waiting for W acknowledgments of successful writes coming back from the replicas. And then later on, when we receive these W acknowledgments, we will acknowledge this to the client. And when we look for the read, again, we're reading from, or we're sending to all of the replicas, and we are happy if we got R reads in the responses from the nodes, and then can return these R reads to the client that was asking for the read. In general, we do not have to put, of course, in these two extremes the parameters that, as we have seen, so N equals W or N equals R, and the other one is 1. for read and write optimized strong consistency, but we can configure N, W, and R, of course, as we want. Here, N is assumed to be just set to a reasonable number, and W and R can then, inside the scope of N, take on different values, and this leads to different configurations that have different properties. Now, the first problem is, how many values do we read? And how many values or how many nodes do we insist on to be written to before we get the acknowledgement? The problem is, if you have the so-called read and write sets not overlapping, then we talk also about a partial quorum. That means W plus R is smaller or equal than N. So this means if you have, let's say, 5 replicas, so 5 machines, and let's say, well, W is 1 and R is 1, of course, then we are writing here and we're reading from here, then we cannot guarantee anything, right? But let's go a bit further. So let's say we're doing 2 writes and reading from 3. It can still be like this, that these are not overlapping, and then we would miss the written value. In this case, we cannot guarantee strong consistency. The other way around, of course, if W plus R is strictly larger than N, then we have the situation that these read and write sets are overlapping. We can also look at a case only for the parameter W here. If this is strictly smaller than N plus 1 divided by 2, then the write sets do not overlap. And you can think now, what does this mean for a system if the write sets of multiple writes by the same client or different clients do not overlap? So we can think of the following configurations. As discussed, we can set W equals N. This is read optimized strong consistency. If R is 1, if R is 2, it's still consistent, of course, but R is 1 stresses the optimization for the read performance. If W is 1 and R is 1, then we have write optimized strong consistency. So if writes are very frequent, then your system could be configured like this if you want strong consistency. The case of W plus R smaller or equal than N, as on the previous slide, this stands for eventual consistency. And here we might miss recent writes, but as the name suggests, eventually the data will be available on all of the replica nodes and everything is consistent again. So it's eventual consistency. And here, if we have W plus R strictly larger than N, we also have a strong consistency because it's guaranteed that the read will always see at least one of the most recent write.